So in this session, we are going to talk about node and nodes group. Okay. So mostly whenever people talk about node in ControlM, they are actually talking about ControlM agent server. Okay. So that's going to be a server where you have ControlM agent is running on. So for example, let's say you posted a question in ControlM community saying that you are not able to execute job on one of the machine. So in that case, let's say someone is replying by saying, did you check the logs on the node? Did you check the proc log on the nodes? Okay, so what exactly they are meaning is that did you check the logs directories on this node machine? So node is basically the machine on which agent is running. Okay, so to be very simple, okay, this is going to be called a node where you have your ControlM agent is running, and this is the IP address of this node, and this is the hostname of this node. Now, I know in node is also used in general term, which is, you know, just to talk about any server. So for example, in our examples also we use a node term, okay, to define a server. But in ControlM, mostly node means an agent, okay, a server or agent machine. Now let's talk about what is nodes group. Okay, so node groups is basically set of, you know, servers which are combined together to act as a single logical node. Okay, so for example, in this case, let's say if I just go back to my previous example, so here you can say that we had only one agent machine. Okay, and let's say on this server we had around 1000 scripts, and all those 1000 scripts are scheduled using a ControlM. So in that case, you are going to define 1000 scripts in ControlM, and all of those scripts are going to have hostname of BI server 01, or if you don't want to give the hostname, you can give the IP address. So in that case, all of those jobs are going to have IP address of 192.168.0.1. Okay, now the problem in this case is, let's say this server goes down. In that case, let's say they introduce a new server, okay, and the IP address or hostname of that new server is different. So in that case, you also need to make changes in all the 1000 jobs which you have configured. And it is easy to do because ControlM also provides you functionality of find and update. So actually you can just search for all the jobs which had IP address of this, and then you can update that by providing the new IP address. Okay, so that's not a big challenge. Okay, but yes, still whenever this changes, you also need to make changes in the name of the machine. Now let's talk about another scenario where you have multiple application servers where you need to execute the jobs. Okay, because most of the time, since this is a production environment, okay, application team is not going to run their application only on single machine. Okay, they are also going to run their application on or in a high availability environment. Okay, so let's consider this example. Let's say there are 1000 scripts and all the 1000 scripts are available on all of these machines. Okay, so there are set of 1000 scripts available on machine 1, and then available on machine 2 and machine 3, and all of these are having their own IP address and host names. Okay, now whenever you are scheduling a job in this case, what application team wants is they want you to run the job only on one machine. Okay, so you can run the job either on node 1. So for example, you can run the job either on node 1, or you can run the job on node 2. Okay, or you can run the job on node 3, but you cannot run the job on all these three nodes at the same time, because that's going to be a case of running duplicate jobs. Okay, so in this case, what exactly you need to do is you need to create a node group, okay, in the ControlM SCCM, which is ControlM Configuration Manager, and there you can give some logical name to these three nodes. Okay, so let's say we can create a node group name which is going to be called BI server, and in this node group name I'm going to add all of these three servers. Okay, so I will add this server. Okay, so let's call it, this is the name, and here you are going to add this node, and then you are going to add this node, and also you are going to add this node. And while you are adding this node, you are also going to define some policy. For example, let's say if you don't want to run the jobs on this server, okay, for let's say in the evening, or let's say between 4 p.m. to 6 p.m., then you can define those kind of policies when you are creating node groups. All of this configuration has to be done in Node Group Configuration Manager. Okay, so which is Control-M Configuration Manager. There you go to Host Management and there you do all of these configuration. Now, let's say there is a requirement to run the job on all of these three machines. Okay, you don't want to run job only on one machine, you want to run the job on all of these three machines. In that case, in the Control-M definition, job definition, you need to select an option which is called execute the job on all the nodes. Okay, in that case, whenever a job is going to be triggered, it is going to be triggered on all these three machines. So this control is actually at the job definition side. Now one thing is, whenever you are defining a job, in that case you don't really need to give the IP address or host name which is of these individual servers. What you need to provide is this logical host name which you have configured. Okay, so what will happen is Control-M server is going to see this logical name and then it is going to look into the mapping, okay, which has been defined in host manager mapping in Control-M configuration manager, and then it is going to understand that okay, it is going to run this job either on one of these machines. Okay, so that's how this communication is actually going to take place. Now in this case, one very important thing is, let's say over a period of time this machine is not useful anymore and there is issue with this server. Okay, and in that case, let's say they just decommission the server and introduce a new server with an IP address of, let's say, 4. Okay, in that case you don't really need to worry about making changes in all the jobs which is defined here at Control-M side. Okay, all you need to do is, in this host group, you are just going to remove the server which is having IP address of 2 and you are going to just add a new server in this host group which is having this new IP which is 4. Okay, so that's how easy it is when you are using host group names rather than using the actual IP addresses.